terms of like the kind of things you've done, I mean, as I said, you don't fit a certain niche in technology. You seem to have just traversed a lot. But one of the things I was most interested in was you came in on certain complex IT projects that saved companies money and, you know, ultimately saved a lot of people money. What is it you bring to the table? Is it that you have an organized mind, or you're a grafter? What is it?
Get stuff done. I think I'm quite, when you have large scale projects or programs that are having, you know, serious issues, it's about being honest and being blunt. A lot of people kind of shy away from that. I'm not afraid to put my mouth in the position and say, right, I will deliver on this. So yeah, if I look at some of the more complex things that I've done, which have been at the time first of type kind of projects for me, I don't like to fail. It's gonna be quite embarrassing. So I've tended to just take it by the bull by the horns and take responsibility. I think a lot of people don't take ownership on projects or programs or anything that they're doing, you know, and whether it be a business or it be, you know, a small scale project. And it is about accountability, and it's about going, that's another success, another tick in the box, walking away with some pride, learning from it. You know, and of course I fail on some things, but you learn from those failures. But yeah, I guess I've also been quite lucky as well, I think.
In terms of the times we're in, I mean, you've been through all the ages of the last decades, two decades, three decades of technology. But you've seen the whole dot-com boom,
yeah.
You've seen the rise of mobile, rise of social. Today we're in a very frenetic time. People are on about iPads, Nexus 7s. It's exciting, but is it dangerous? Do you think that this is just another age that we're going to go through that could either excel or end horribly?
If we're smart and we learn some lessons from history, then it won't go as wrong as it did at the end of the dot-com boom. But I'm seeing a lot of similarities right now in the next 2 years. I can just feel there's another one around the corner. And ironically, I was just in a taxi on the way here saying, a lot of the stuff I'm seeing in press releases or in products in general, it's kind of back in the 90s again. And I'm kind of like, well, we just put some new words in there and we've kind of moved technology forward. So it is a bit scary because there's another generation behind me. They're very young and smart and smarter than I was, but they're making some of the same mistakes, and it's getting people to listen. And I think if we're really smart, you know, in governments as well, we can have another dot-com boom and reinvest that money. And, you know, wait for the bubble to burst, because what goes up must come down. But yeah, it's really exciting. I mean, I've since the last boom, you know, the end of the 90s, early 2000, it's been some time. And the market kind of got a little bit stagnated. And in the last year, I'm seeing some real energy back in, like everyone wants to be back in the tech space again. And if you come to things like this, you can just see the energy and enthusiasm. And I guess it's about being realistic as well, yeah? And you know, not putting something up on a screen saying you're making 100 grand this year and you're gonna make 64 million in 4 years' time. I think we need to be realistic again and not get carried away with valuations, hopefully, this time.
In terms of your current endeavor, a property market, like in Ireland, when someone says property market, we shudder, right? but in the UK, there's various plays that are kind of doing quite well. I think Zumba is that one. Yeah. Tell me about property market, how it plays a role.
Right, okay, so we're the property page. So it's one of my ventures, completely new vertical for me. So my other co-founder in that business is from the real estate market. The reason I was interested is that there is another generation behind us who search differently, who want different things, right? So they don't just want to go and buy a house these days in London. They want to know the pub down the road's any good. They want to know there's deals around the corner. So for us right now, the property page, we were kind of proving the concept. We've organically grown the business with no funding. So we're just self-funded up until now. It's going great. We're about to launch in Sydney with 700 branches. It's only been going since January. And we've got 500 in London right now. And it's going to be one of those businesses that actually, hopefully, we're looking to bring actually to Ireland. But also we want to make sure that it can organically grow and we don't have to take funding, you know, and that's kind of where I come from, that school now. I used to be the school of let's spend loads of money and blow cash. Now I'm more like let's organically grow these businesses, and if there's an opportunity that we have to be in and it's 2 months, then yeah, okay, we may need to seek outside funding. But no, it's going good. It's going good. Very different market. UK is very different to Australia. The US, I'm not even going to try and tackle that one right now. But yeah, it's being received well. There's still a lot of work to do. It's very early, I would say.